Good afternoon, everybody. This is Lisa, Connecticut Garden Gal, and I want to do a little peek inside my urban worm bag. I have my phone on a tripod today, so I'm not sure how that's going to go because I'm not used to working with a tripod. I can tell you immediately it's not showing the entire view of the worm bag, because if I put it any higher to get a bigger picture, then it's going to be too far away to show details. So I'll just move the phone right here right quick just to show you one edge to the other and what it looks like in the top. And one of my Cornish Rex cats is in the room, and if I'm talking, it's talking. So I'm sorry if he gets annoying. Max, you're going to have to not be the star of the show, buddy. Not today. Max. Shh. So there you go. There's Max. He wants to be a worm. The big bump you see in the middle. A few days ago, I did a video that I had a pumpkin that had gone soft. So rather than saving it for carving, I cut it up and put a little bit outside to catch some wild worms and inside into all my worm bins. And underneath this cardboard is the inside piece. Now, I don't expect to find any worms around it yet, other than maybe a couple, because it is so new and I didn't pre-freeze it or anything, so it wasn't like something that they would right away go devouring into. But I'm going to start by removing that cover and taking it out, or at least moving it to the side. What I'm going to do is actually flip this backwards. Oh yes, they did find it. I'm going to pick the camera up here for a minute and hold it down in there. So here's the pumpkin. I'm going to need a new Band-Aid after this. And even though I had it sticking out, I didn't fully bury it. You can see the worms that have gathered around it. Some of them. Is this cardboard? Of course it is. Yeah, you can see these guys have already found it, and they're quite happy about it. Now, this bag is a mix of red wigglers, some European night crawlers, and a few Canadian night crawlers that I found outside, and maybe one or two Indian blue worms. And I say maybe because I think a couple got out when I first acquired them and I tossed them in here, but I haven't actually seen them. So now, of course, my camera doesn't want to cooperate, but so yeah, they did find the pumpkin already, but there are far more worms in here than this, so they clearly need to be elsewhere. I'm gonna move the way this tripod is situated here. So, okay, let's take the pumpkin. I'm going to put this pumpkin over there and put those worms on it. And I can actually hold the tripod in my hand. Now, I put some, what you're seeing here, these are milkweed seed pods. A few of them had broken off, and I just figured this silk floss that's on the inside, they would like it. You're going to see cocoons all throughout here, no doubt. No doubt at all. There's a lot of cardboard in here, and where there's cardboard, there's a lot of breeding going on. Yeah, you can see that's a worm ball with cocoons. Or a collection of worms. I don't know if it's a ball, but they are not, there's nothing, let me put it down for a sec, there's no food source here. I believe these guys were heading towards the pumpkin patch, because I haven't added anything else anything else at all. So we will add them to the top of the pumpkin over there. Of course, the avocado shells, they will exist throughout. And I'm not going to take the time to dig to the bottom of this bag because the video would be 45 minutes long. This is a Euro. You could see the difference, the color difference there from the Red Wigglers. But there aren't many. This I put in just a couple of days ago. It was a stem from last year's sunflower plants. And I know they love going into tubes and sticks and whatnot. So I gave them something to add to their playground. And I'm hoping my phone is going to cooperate. You can see cocoons. They're falling. They just fell. But even though they fell, they exposed more. So you're going to see cocoons everywhere. This bin populates like crazy. I don't know at which point I'm going to need to break it apart because it is an urban worm bag. Well, here's another tube. I wonder. Now, this one isn't broken open. I wonder if there's. If we can. What's gone in it? Yeah, just a few worms. I believe I put that in yesterday or the day prior. So I just am kind of showing the moisture level. Oh, there is some sort of food. There was something right there. I don't know. Oh, they smell banana. So that was banana. Just showing the moisture level, the casting color, and the food source. I could dig to the bottom, and the results are going to be the same through and through. I just dropped the Canadian nightcrawler there. And you can see a freshly laid cocoon right in the center to the left of that brown stick. And what you'll notice if I get my phone to cooperate is there aren't any mites. You can see a springtail there on that black stick, dark brown stick that's vertical. That's a good guy. But you won't see any bad guys. Since I've switched to a heavy carb food source, heavy carbon, the mites have disappeared. There's no more mites in this bin, which is a wonderful thing. So yeah, that's it. I'm not going to dig to the bottom. This really wasn't needing any maintenance. I just wanted to give an overview of how it's doing. The only other thing I will do is peek to the side where it's heavily filled with cardboard, which is this side. You can see as I turn the cardboard over, move this light, as I turn the cardboard over, you're going to see lots and lots of worms between the pumpkin and the cardboard. These guys are pretty happy. Guys and gals. Uniworms. Whatever it is. Yeah, they love it. One more turnover. And they're good. Everybody's good. The bin is doing exactly what it should be doing. The worms are, they're eating, they're breathing. The moisture level is spot on. Heavy cardboard kind of maintains moisture. Doesn't dry out easy. And the color of the castings is really good. The texture of them is really good. And I'm pleased with it. So a couple more bins I want to do updates on. So I'm going to cut this one off here now. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them below the video. If you haven't already subscribed and you would like to, please do. And ring the notification bell so you get updates if that's what you'd like. And I hope to be doing another video with you and for you again very soon. For now, Me and my fat worms are signing off. Bye-bye.